Welcome to Abhipedia, powered by Abhimanyu IAS. This is Dr. Vivek Rana, decoding science and tech topics from current as well as mains point of view. This is the seventh lecture of Science and Tech Value Addition series with me. So I'll be covering the most important themes which are in news from pre and mains point of view. So topic for this week is once again an interesting one, and most of you must have followed it by now, because it was in news for two reasons. Two variants of BrahMos cruise missiles have been successfully test fired. If you could recall, in our last lecture we have seen that night trial of Agni 3 ended in a failure, but DRDO this time has bounced back and has delivered two successes in a single day. So I'll be discussing what is BrahMos is all about, why it is in news, and then what could be the likely prelim question which can be asked from it. So without wasting any time, I would like to highlight that this is a major trial which was carried out on a single day and two versions. There was a land attack version which was tested from integrated test train from Chandipur, and there was Air Force version which was tested from Kalaikunda in West Bengal. So what is the significance? What are we likely to gain from this test is the core of this lecture. So first of all, what are things we should know about these BrahMos cruise missile? Whenever, as you could recall in last lecture, I had discussed few themes which are important from missile section, and we must be thorough with them. Otherwise, we cannot attempt UPSC prelims questions, because generally two or three statements are asked and they generally revolve around the core pillars of that missile. So first of all is the development part. What is the key organizations which are involved in development of BrahMos cruise missile? Is it totally indigenous project, or it's a collaborative project, or what we call the joint venture one? So here you have to understand that this BrahMos missile was developed outside IGMDP program. So it's a joint venture between two powerhouses, India and Russia. So it's not enough to just know about the names of the countries. You must be thorough with the exact organizations which have developed. From India, it's a obvious one. There is DRDO. And in case of Russia, it is NPOM. Okay, so you can memorize this easy term, that it's NPOM which has developed this key strategic missile for India. After development, we have to focus on that what is the nomenclature of this missile. As you could see that in BrahMos, B and M are in capital letter, rest are in small letters. So there is some significance of this name. You have to understand at times some statements can be based on nomenclature as well. So this BrahMos missile is based on name of two rivers, and those rivers are on expected lines. One is from India, another one is from Russia. The Indian river is mighty Brahmaputra river, and Russian river is Moskva. So if you are familiar with defense affairs, this might be an expected theme for you, but all of those who are covering this theme for the first time through this series, this is an important set of information. You cannot make mistake in names of the rivers for BrahMos. Now after the nomenclature and the development part has been decoded, the main part is the description part, that how this missile is to be described. There are certain classifications which have to be followed while describing the missile. So I will be just highlighting, whenever BrahMos is test fired for any year, the same set of facts appear. So generally examiner takes up this descriptive part as a base and formulates a statement. So BrahMos is a medium range ramjet missile which is a supersonic cruise missile which is capable of carrying both conventional as well as nuclear weapon in its role as a tactical weapon. So here you have to understand the keywords like the range. You should be familiar with the exact range of BrahMos. The conventional BrahMos range which we are talking about is, to be specific, 290 kilometers. So you should be thorough with the kilometer part. So it's classified as a short to medium range. in case of cruise categories, because India also has a Nirbhaya missile, which is a cruise missile. It has a range of 1500 kilometers, but it's of subsonic category, so this is totally a different theme altogether. Then you have to understand, examiner might like to confuse you cruise with the ballistic missiles, because Agni one, if you could recall, I had emphasized, was a ballistic missile, but here BrahMos is a cruise missile. Just to brush up, what is a cruise missile? Cruise missile generally travel close to the surface of sea or water, initially at subsonic speed, alleviate its speed to supersonic when they are just about to hit the target, giving them advanced stealth features. So they are difficult to detect, and they are not going in atmosphere, so they are not being detected by airborne radar systems as well. So this gives them a tactical advantage whenever there is a direct one-on-one combat. So here you have to understand the cruise world as well as range, as well as they are capable of carrying both nuclear and conventional warhead, and it's one of the heaviest missiles which we have in cruise category, which I will just highlight in the final part of this theme. So you have to focus on the description part. After that, the speed becomes important, because generally when these cruise missiles are being asked, you would see there would be written that speed of BrahMos is Mach 2.8. This Mach 2.8 signifies that this missile is capable of traveling with speed almost thrice the speed of sound. So this is the gold standard which we follow for describing this missile. So it's one of the fastest cruise missiles which is operational at the moment in the shipping category. So you have to memorize this 2.8 Mach word as well. Finally, what are the special features for which this BrahMos missile is remembered or is likely characterized by defense authorities? It is touted as one of the fastest cruise missile which is operational in anti-ship missile category. So this is the one of its key milestone and the speed which we have just highlighted. Secondly, it's a multi-platform, multi-role missile. It is not just limited to use by just warships of Indian naval fleet. It also can be fired from submarines. It can be used from land attack version by military authorities as well as air force wing as well. So this is a multi-platform missile. As well as it's based on technology of fire and forget. At times you will see some of the missiles written as fire and forget principle. So fire and forget means once you have fired, it does not require much guidance further. It hits the target with precision and accuracy. And the test we have just conducted, both of them has exhibited those precision and accuracy. They have hit the pinpoint targets. So this is another key angle. And then they are capable of carrying nuclear warheads as well. Their original weight is around 2.5 tons. But they can carry around 200 to 300 ton of warhead. So they are capable of delivering the short nuclear warhead if the situation demands. So this is the another key aspect of this. And the stealth features are almost advanced as compared to ballistic missile. That's another advantage of it. So these key features can be incorporated in one of the statements. So I'm expecting you to be thorough with these themes as well. So by now you have a broad picture what this BrahMos cruise missile is about, what are the advantages which India perceives. Now, why this missile is being covered in our this science and tech value edition series? There must be some current angle, because if you could see, I have covered all the themes from current perspective. So there are two angles to it, why this missile is suddenly in news in this month of December. The first one is the unexpected lines, which most of the newspapers have already followed at the back page of the leading newspapers, that two different versions of BrahMos, two variants is the right term for it, have been successfully test fired in a single day. The first one was test fired from integrated test range from Chandipur. So make sure you are thorough with the geographical angle as well, that where exactly is Chandipur. Chandipur is in Odisha. And this was a land attack version which was successfully test fired. These versions have already been test fired multiple times with success. But the key, because this BrahMos has different versions, as I have said, The Air Force one as well as submarine one are in testing phase, but land and Air Force one are operational. So this test is not some big thing or to boast about. It was expected that it would be carried out successfully. The airborne one is a important one because it has some inclination angle as well, for which it has been highlighted. The airframe as well as fuel management system were of indigenous nature. So further strengthening or validating our Make in India progress, which we are showcasing at the moment. So that's the indigenous technology is a key theme for UPSC. So that's the key advantage for which this airborne version would be remembered. So this gives the functional or strength to our defense forces that we are being able to test fire missiles with precision and accuracy. But that's not all in this BrahMos series. We have to understand there is an IR angle as well. You could see that the second reason for why it is in news is that India, if you are following SIPRI reports, have traditionally been world largest importer. Only in current year, it's at second in the list of importers. Saudi Arabia is the top most importer. So we need to export as well few of the items. So this is one of the export products which can come in handy for us. Philippines has shown interest. Their defense secretary has confirmed that in January 2020, this contract is to be finalized and we are likely to export this. And this, why this export is taking place? Because if you could recall the IR angle, India has now been entered into MTCR group, Missile Technology Control Regime. And that allows us to even export such items. And we could even increase its range, because under MTCR, up to more than 500 kilometer range missiles can also be exported. So this is the key dimension. And this Philippines angle is more important for our ACT-EAST policy as well, because in ACT-EAST policy we are trying to strengthen our bonds with Southeast Asian nations like Philippines. And why is Philippines suddenly interested in acquiring this BrahMos missile? Because if you are following the disputed island series, there is one of the disputed islands partly, because China some years back have unlawfully annexed the Scarborough Shoal, and these disputed islands are a bone of contention between these two countries. So it wants to safeguard its interest and don't want those episodes to be repeated again and again. So this is a tactical move by Philippines. And this shows that our ACT-EAST policy is strengthening from not only diplomatic front, but also the security and defense aspects are also being integrated. So this is the another key advantage of this Philippines. So make sure you are trying, because once you start integrating IR, science and tech, environment, then and geography as well, then the real depth to your preparation comes into play. So this is what you have to do from static as well as the current part, but make sure that you are covering the theme 360 degrees. And how this theme would be covered 360 degrees? By adding few values from your own, which I am not going to discuss in detail. The first value addition which you could do in this topic is that just go through the variants of BrahMos missile. Because what I have discussed is the conventional BrahMos missile, but there are other key versions apart from the submarine, ship, land and air force one. The first one is the extended version of BrahMos. It has surpassed the conventional range, because that was recently test fired and it could travel up to 450 kilometers. So make sure if the examiner is saying that BrahMos is capable of, extended version of BrahMos is capable of traveling to a distance of around 450 kilometers, that option could also be picked up if the word can is being used. Then there's another ambitious project which is currently going on. It is BrahMos 2. This BrahMos 2 is the next version of BrahMos, which is once again being developed by India and Russia. Rest facts remain the same. It's the advanced version of BrahMos 1, because we see the BrahMos is a supersonic cruise missile. BrahMos 2 is touted to be hypersonic cruise missile. And when this hypersonic tag is given to a missile, when it surpasses the speed of Mach more than 5. So you have to understand, it's likely to be touching Mach 6 to 7, and it is going to revolutionize the cruise missile category. But it's still under development and there's a long way to go. Most likely 2024 is the year in which we are going to hear more about this BrahMos 2. And one of the setbacks in BrahMos is it's quite heavy, 2.5 tons. So already the work is going on BrahMos NG. This NG acronym you have to understand is stands for next generation. This is going to be the lighter version of BrahMos, 1.5 tons, and in length it is going to be 3 meters short from the existing one. So this is another one which is the variant of BrahMos. So make sure you just go through the broad picture of what BrahMos is all about. Then you must revise once again the classification of missile part, because that's the part on which the most questions are generally asked. I am once again repeating the 3 broad categories. The first classification is based on the range. You should be thorough with the ranges of ballistic missiles, like when missile is called short range, when it's called intermediate range, and when it is called intercontinental. Then the second classification, which we have covered in our class lecture, was of based on launch site as well as the target site. Like when we say surface to surface missile, it means it's launched from surface, it is hitting the enemy surface. Surface to air means from surface to the air angle. So, and air to air is there, and from now air to land is also there. So that's classification part you should revise, and also the ballistic and cruise one. Like the current lecture is revolving around cruise one. If you want to know more about the ballistic one, just go through the lecture which we had covered in the Agni night trial of Agni 3. That's given in your series which we are covering. And finally, you could give an overview or quick revision of that IGMDP program, because it is different from IGMDP. IGMDP is Integrated Guided Missile Development Program, which was spearheaded by APJ Abdul Kalam and Anand Paas Sarathy. That we had already discussed in last lecture, so I am not repeating it. So that's it for the BrahMos cruise missile. Let's have a practice session with the objective question. And once again, it's on expected lines. If you had understood today's lecture, this question is a straightforward one. I am just asked which of the following statement is correct regarding BrahMos cruise missile. The first statement you could easily eliminate, because I have emphasized numerous number of nth times the word cruise. So you cannot just pick up that it's a ballistic missile. It's a totally wrong option. So A is eliminated. Then let's see if the B one holds some future. In B option, you can see that I have just interchanged the country, because India has a strategic partnerships with multiple developed countries, US, France, UK, Germany. So at times, even Israel, so at times whenever these joint venture projects are generally confused by UPSC by changing the country. So make sure you are thorough with it, since the lecture has totally emphasized that it's a Moscow-Russian angle. So you cannot pick the France option. B is probably the easiest option in this question to get, is being eliminated. Then the third one is a tricky one. If you have not covered the lecture, this might have confused some of the students that whether it's a part of IGMDP or not. In IGMDP, there are just 5 missiles. There is Agni, Trishul, there is Prithvi, Akash, and Nag. So this was not originally part of IGMDP program. It has been developed separately. So the third one is eliminated. The fourth one is obvious answer, and is the key theme of this BrahMos, which is revolving around the current affair which we have discussed. Because at times, when you are reading the text, it's generally written that it's the fastest anti-ship cruise missile which is available. And we tend to just, our minds sometimes get blocked and we think that it's only a ship version is available. But this missile can be test fired, because can word I am using, and it's in testing state. It can be from multiple platform, whether it's a submarine, whether it's a ship, whether it's a land, or whether it's an air. So this is it for now. I'll be back soon with another science and tech value addition series, and you could subscribe to the channel, as well as follow the other series which are currently going on. A lot of themes are currently underway. There's an economy series, there's a disputed island, there's a current affair ecology, whatnot. So make sure you are choosing the value addition courses as per your needs. And as the prelims is approaching, we need to be more proactive, and these value addition series are going to be useful in the long run. So thank you very much. I hope this session was useful.